Learn about the different sections of the Site Description Editor to record the conditions under which the trial is conducted. We will also discuss RTF fields, multi-field personal lists, repeating sections, and F5 entry field help as we go. To follow along with this video, open the tutorial trial record site info. The site description is an ARM editor that consists of many different sections to enter trial site-related information. These sections are listed within the navigation bar to the left and also display as tabs at the top of the site description editor, so are often referred to as tabs. As we discussed in the Create a New Protocol video, a study definition defines the structure of how data is entered in ARM. Thus, it has a big impact on how the site description appears in the trial. This example trial was saved with the standard GAL study definition, which the majority of ARM studies use. Note that it is possible for other trials to look a little different based upon a different study definition that is used. The General Trial tab contains the Trial Status entry field, noting the progress of the trial through the year. Study rules can be defined to trigger only at a certain status, so be sure to update this field to ensure required data is entered at the appropriate time. We will cover rules and validation in a later video. Enter the date of trial initiation and completion, as well as the location of the trial, especially the GPS coordinates. The next section is the objectives and conclusions. These are large comment fields that support text with formatting, tables, and images. It's easy to paste content from a Word document or mark up the text once it is in the trial. This content is included when creating a site description report, so these kinds of entry fields can enhance your reports. This information is saved in rich text format, so we call them RTF fields for short. The Contacts tab is a great example of a multi-field personal list. When multiple entry fields describe a single entity, in this case, a contact, first fill in the details for the entity. Then open the validation list for the initial field in the group and save the contents of all the fields together as a single unit. This is just like when we added treatments to our personal list when setting up the protocol. The Crop Description tab contains many fields for documenting aspects of the crops in this study. All of these fields pertain to a single crop, so to document an additional crop or variety, insert another repeating section. A repeating section is a grouped set of fields in ARM, often in a table row or column, that describe a single entity. This group can be replicated in order to document more than one such entity, like an additional crop or performing another application. The pest description similarly uses repeating sections to document the pests in this study. To learn about what information should be entered into an entry field, press the F5 button or the red plus sign button on the toolbar to view the entry field help. You can also search this system to determine where certain information should be entered into ARM. Use the Maintenance section to document products that are applied to all experimental units, independent of the trial design. Describe the soil composition at the trial site on the Soil tab. The Weather tab documents the soil and weather conditions that the trial experienced. Import weather data from any weather station by creating a custom data connection. See Import Custom Weather Data for more information. The Application tab describes the method, timing, and placement of the application, along with the weather conditions experienced at the time of each application. The Application Equipment tab documents the equipment used. We cover this in more depth in a different video, but note that the application equipment is another example of a multi-field personal list. Document the stage of the crops and pests at the time of each application. Any information already entered in these sections act as instructions from the protocol, so be sure to update with the actual stages present when the application occurred. Enter comments about a treatment relating to its application. This is a free text field, which has space for several lines of text, but without any formatting. There's a spot for general notes about the trial, some of which are automatically generated by ARM. And any significant deviations from the protocol plan should be documented. The SE Definitions tab defines standard assessments, SEs, used in the trial. This feature is also discussed in a separate video. Finally, the Protocol Instructions is the rest of the information copied from the protocol. Since these are instructions for the trial, they cannot be changed in the trial.